Hello and welcome to another class of this Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I will be creating a menu and adding the applications created so far within this training so that we have all applications organized in a way that can be accessed by the end user. You can create as many menus as you like and link them all together to display and organize your project applications as you please. But for the purpose of this video, I will create a single centralized menu. To create a menu, I will need to create a new application. I will select the menu application and I will leave the default name and then select the create button. By default, the menu application will open on the menu items option as indicated within the left-hand menu. And at the top of the main view is where you can manage the menu items. I have here first a checkbox which allows for multi-selection of items once included within the menu. The next button is to insert new items or application. The second inserts sub-items once we have main items available within the menu. Then there is also a delete option. To the right of that, you can import applications, which when clicked, opens the application selection window. Next to the import button, there is also a move up, down, left, and right buttons, so you can adjust the menu items. So I will go ahead and add one item to the menu. I'll give it the name maintenance. And now what I'm going to do is group the customers, suppliers, employees, products, as well as a few other applications underneath this single menu. So now I will click on the import applications and then simply look for them and select them within the list of applications available. At the bottom of this list, I also have some boxes that I can check or uncheck all of the available applications. I will check them all and simply deselect a few of the applications that I have here. And when ready, click the import button. So I have them already selected as I've just added them, and I will adjust their position to actually enter inside of the maintenance folder. And now within the bottom preview, we can see now that all of the applications which I've just imported are within the maintenance menu item. So I will go ahead and create another folder or another item within the menu. And this time I will call this, say, lists. And within this list, I will now adjust all of the other applications which I already have within the menu. I will select only the grid applications and I will adjust them into the lists folder, add them and save our application. Now we currently see within the maintenance that the new list folder as well as the list or grid applications which I have added are now within a submenu of maintenance. Now I will want to adjust that so that we have two separate menu locations. So I need to select the entire segment or applications which are grouped and then adjust their position to the left, which will then present them as a separate item within the menu. Okay, so now I'll go ahead and adjust the titles of the applications. Okay, so now I've made adjustments to their labels. Now within each menu item, I can also provide a hint which will be displayed on mouse over of the menu item. Below that, we have the link where we can manually change the application to which it is linked. I can also provide an icon for the menu item, as well as the option to use Font Awesome or only text and an image. Selecting Font Awesome will provide further options where we can then select the Font Awesome item. Where we can then select the Font Awesome icon to be included for the menu. We can also change the icon color, the hover color, as well as the disabled icon color. The target allows us to adjust what this link or how this link will open a new window. So on selecting the products link within the lists menu item, I can select to open this within the same window, a new window, or even leave the application. Selecting leave the application will actually log you out and take you back to the login page. So that is ideally used for the logout selection. Okay, so let's have a look at the menu as it is now, and I'm going to go ahead and run it. And now within the menu, we can see we have our maintenance and our lists available. And selecting any of these, we can open them up within tabs, which is then the default. Here we can also see the products menu item, which I had added an icon to. So let's return back to Scriptcase. And here what we will do is I will add a submenu item, call it employees. I will adjust its position so that it is a submenu item of the list menu item. And here I will adjust the layout of the employees list, which is there, and place that within the new employee folder. Adjust the name of that employee and then employees for the list. If I go ahead and run that again, we can now see within the menu that we have our submenu item. So as you can see within the menu structure that we have there already, we can include, okay, so let's return back to Scriptcase and add some further menu items so that the menu is a little more filled out and we have some further applications a little more organized than what we have at the moment. So I will go ahead and create a new folder, and this time I will call it customers. I will adjust that to the top, and then I will also place the add customers as well as the two customer lists inside of the customer section. Now notice that where I've had the customer still selected, it will also adjust this layer. So I do need to make sure that I deselect that, and then I am able to move the other elements into position. Let me correct that again now. Move customers back to the top, move it in, and I will also apply the same to the other two applications. Okay, so I'm gonna add one more new item within this list, and this one I'm going to call charts, and this time I will import all of the charts that we've previously created, adjust its position so now it's displayed within the menu correctly and not as a submenu, and then I will go ahead and click the import applications button, and within the application selection I can select the charts that we have here, and I will also go ahead and include the PDF reports. So I will import those and again adjust their position. I will go ahead and deselect them to avoid any misplacement, and again we can go ahead and change the labels of each of these menu items. Okay, so now that I have added the charts also, we have the new items listed here also. So we nearly have our menu complete. Now we have one item left to add, and that would then be the logout or leave option. So as an example, I will go ahead and add that, and I will adjust again the positioning of the menu item and move it into the top layer of the menu. So now you see it here, item 20. I will go ahead and adjust the name, even though we don't have a security system created yet. Adding the logout button is quite important. Now when adding this, we need to change the target to leave. And now when the user clicks the logout button, it will take them either to the security center login page. It will either take them to the security login page or exit the application which is currently available, pending if the security system is installed and configured with the menu application. So within Scriptcase, we have multiple options available for the customization of the menu. So the first one we have is the addition of images or icons using font awesome icons. Now I will go ahead and add one to the logout, because I think it's always best to have an icon there. Select the font awesome icon, and here I will search for a logout, select an icon I want to use. You can go ahead and change the icon color, so I will select a reddish, and also change the hover color to be white. Now if I go ahead and run the menu application again, we'll now see that the logout button also has an icon. Clicking the logout button will exit the application. To the right of the menu, we can change the orientation of the menu from horizontal to vertical. So I'll change to vertical and run the form again. Let's have a fresh look. Now we can see that we have a vertical layout for our menu instead of a horizontal. Back in Scriptcase, we can also change the theme available. So below we can see the preview. We have some various examples here, which are available for use, and we can apply any of these to our application. Now do notice within Scriptcase that when selecting a menu orientation, for some themes, the orientation is set, meaning the one I've just selected is horizontal only, as indicated here within the list. Scrolling up, I can see horizontal and vertical, as well as the folder for which they are available. So these are all available within the Scriptcase folder. And if I scroll down, I can see here that I have the public folder, horizontal and vertical menus, and scrolling much further down, I will find that I then only have the horizontal menus available, as well as then also the project folder. And here we have the user folder, and above that, you will find the project folder. Once you're happy with the layout of your menu items, as well as the theme that you're currently using, then you can go ahead and add some further items. So selecting settings within the left-hand menu, and then viewing the settings for desktop or mobile, we can change various options. For instance, for mobile devices, we can change how the menu is displayed, if it is a navigation or a normal menu, if we hide the menu, its initial mode being hidden or open, a float menu, as well as the option to hide menu by clicking an item. On the desktop, we have many more options. Here we can select to include the language, as well as the theme selection within the menu. We can also add a scroll bar. change the horizontal alignment, include a friendly URL, change the width, height, as well as the iframe width and height. And then below that, we can customize further options for the navigation. For instance, within the navigation here, we can select to open new selected items of the menu in a tab. So let's return back to the menu and have a quick look at that. Within the menu, when selecting one of these options, you can see that new tabs are created, allowing to view multiple forms or applications at the same time. Now back in Scriptcase, if I disable that option and run the application again, and then viewing the menu, now within the menu, first of all, we'll select an item, and you can see that no tabs are now created, and each application is handled independently. Do also notice up the right-hand corner here, we now have the language selection, which is available for the product, as well as the theme selection, where we can allow the end user to customize or use a selected theme, which is available for the platform. So let's return back to Scriptcase, and this time we're going to have a look at the toolbar option within the left-hand menu. And within the toolbar settings, we can here add further buttons to our menu. So again, we have some options here, insert a sub item, add a separator, to remove the item, as well as then the up, down, left, and right adjustments. If I go ahead and click on the insert item, a new button will be added. So I can select here, first of all, the type that I want displayed, if it will be displayed as a button, as an image, or as a simple link. To the right, I can select which application this will open. Clicking that will open the application selection. And again here, I will go ahead and say, select the calendar and import that. We can then adjust the label. So I will change the label name and call it WebCow. Selecting display, I can change if I only want to display the text, only an image, text and an image, only a font awesome icon, or text as well as the font awesome icon. We can apply a hint and also specify the icon positioning and the CSS styling of this button that we are adding. So now if I go ahead and run our application, and now within the menu, we can see that we have a new button here called WebCow, and that then opens the calendar. Let's return back to Scriptcase and make some further adjustments to the toolbar. So we've already added our button within the toolbar. We can add as many buttons as we'd like here. We can also add icons, images, and so forth within the button added and change the style just below that. So I'm going to change the style to the Google style. I will then also access settings again. And here I will change the toolbar alignment to be centered. We'll also go ahead and add the select language and select theme option and run the menu again. Now within the menu, we can see that we now have the WebCow button positioned in the center. And to the top right, we also have then the language selection of available languages for the project, as well as the theme selection, allowing us to provide alternative themes or visuals for the platform. Okay, so let's return back to Scriptcase. This time we're going to go ahead and view layout. Clicking and expanding that, we will have then the option menu structure. Within the menu structure, we can add multiple layers, and we can adjust the layout of each layer by dragging down and placing the container available here into the menu layout. Now I can place one layer at a time and do need to save it in between adding new layers. Within the layer, we will then also have an edit button, which allows us to make adjustments to what is displayed within this specific layer. So we can first of all change the name of the layer, provide a different width, which I will go ahead and increase to 8%. We can adjust the alignment from left, center, and right, and select to display this layer in the first place. Below that, we can indicate what kind of data we want to display. So as a sample, I will add title. I will leave the default, change the background color to a green maybe, and go ahead and save my changes. Running the menu application again and viewing the menu, we can now see that the title that I have just added is now within the left-hand segment of the menu. So let's return back to Scriptcase and make some further adjustments here. So first of all, I will edit the first layer again. I will change the title to an image and open the image manager. Within the image manager, I will select a Scriptcase logo, add it, and remove the background color I had added previously, and then go ahead and save those changes. Now, if I run the menu again, and within the menu, I now have the Scriptcase logo presented within the left-hand side of the menu. So let's make some further changes to the menu. And this time we're going to move the menu items to the right. So accessing settings, and then this time change the horizontal alignment of the menu from left to write and run the menu again. And now we can see that our menu items are located on the right hand side instead of the left. So let's return back to Scriptcase and have another look at the layers available. So returning to the left hand menu and menu structure and clicking the edit button. Now within each layer, we have the option to add further items if we so please. I can keep clicking the add button and add as many elements within this layer as I so please. For instance, I can include values, libraries, methods also, which allow further customization of the menu and what is displayed within it. For instance, we can add full-fledged applications, links, and so forth, allowing quicker access to logouts, profile information, and so forth. Okay, so I will go ahead and delete the final two that we have here and leave the second item that I've just added. And here I will include a value and I will specify Scriptcase training as the value, save it, and run the menu again. Now within the menu application, we can see here below the logo that the Scriptcase training is there available. We adjust the color of the text to be white so that it is visible. And then when we're ready, we can click the save changes, run the menu again, and the text is now displayed in white. Now within the menu, you can see all the applied changes to the layout that we have applied. And of course, I could make further adjustments to the width of the icon layer and also the newly added text layer and include something on the right of the menu if I wanted to. Let's go ahead and add another layer to this menu. And this time I'm going to drag another layer over to the right-hand side of the menu. Here I will edit that. And this time I will include a date. We can add a date format and then click the save changes button and run the application. And now within the menu application, we can see on the right hand side that I now also have the date displayed there. Again, I can make further customizations to the font color, the background of this layer, as well as the background of the text and so forth. Now in general, when using a menu application, it is usually better to use a header and footer. So within the menu layout, I can select the header and footer element. I can select display the header and adjust what is then displayed within the header element. So first of all, I need to add a title. So I would include training. For the SC value, I won't include anything. I will go ahead and run the application. Now within the menu, I now have a header applied with a slight title, with a title and the menu below it. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.